Welkom Railways Africa viewers to Trackside. This time I'm here at Galison Manufacturing. We're going to be talking about Galison's wagons for the rail sector and wagons for the mining sector. However, specifically for this particular Trackside, we're going to be seeing the actual manufacturing process from start to finish for the wagons that Galison is supplying to Angola.
This is our design office where we come up with the concepts of our wagons and do the complete design process. You can see a finite element analysis being done on a new ore wagon, also showing how we do our 3D drawings to get a good idea of how we'll manufacture our wagons.
Here we are, we're in our parts preparation workshop, and we have all of the modern equipment to make the parts ourselves. The high definition plasma cutting machine, we have automatic saws, and we have automatic drills, so that once the steel comes out of here, it's ready to be assembled into the wagon.
From the design side, you bring in your flat sheet of metal, you do all the programming and cutting, it then stockpiles and goes into your product. So that must enable like quite good turnaround in terms of your delivery.
We hold lots of steel in stock to work competitively by lowering the cost of our parts by doing them ourselves.
So this is a prime example of the sort of equipment that Galison employs to manufacture our wagons efficiently and to the highest quality standards. This is a Ocean Avenger drill. This drill is drilling a chassis for a container wagon at the moment. As you can see, it's a hydraulic drill and it's completely computer controlled. It's been programmed so that the hole drilled in exactly the same place every time and at about 5 times the efficiency of an old manual drilling machine.
So Gary, it's quite impressive to see the robotic welding. I think that deals with a few things like quality and efficiency.
Most of the subcomponents of the wagon are welded in robots because of the quality and the efficiency of the robot. The welds can be much deeper and they can be weaved and pulsed. What's welding in the robot now are all the arms or the stabilizers of the wagon. A lot of the sub-assemblies are all done in robots for the quality purpose.
Quite interesting to see the flat steel arrive, be cut, and then like now the welding.
A robot also becomes a good quality controller because if it doesn't fit into the jigs, the robots won't weld it. It's very important that the parts are made correctly. Hence we use the high definition cutters. All the subcomponents here, when we go and see where they're fabricating, you'll see how they put these together and they must fit exactly.
And these are another part of the sub-assemblies for the wagons. You can have a look at the quality of the welds from the robot. And you can also see that all the edges are beveled as there is specialized welding to be done on these units. But these are completed and will end up going to the factory where the wagons are assembled.
Andrew, this is where I assume the jigsaw puzzle comes together. The wagon is then fitted out and goes through a process.
That's right. This is our assembly bay. If you look around us, you'll see some of the parts that we saw earlier. Over here, we have an assembly jig. This wagon has just been taken out of the jig, and they're doing quality checks on dimensions on this wagon before it goes to the welder. So these are all the parts that we saw being made earlier in the press brakes, on the high-definition plasma machines, on the drills. And as I said, some of the already welded parts in the robot. This is an assembly jig where we're just starting the assembly. The chassis that we saw being drilled earlier, the assembly jig is made exactly so that every wagon goes in and comes out exactly the same. Here we can see the headstock being fitted to the chassis, and all the other parts will be attached there and tacked together before going for welding. This side we're doing the brake piping. We have jigs where we've worked on the sizes of the length of the pipes, where all the curves have to be, and all that curves is actually done to AAR specifications as well. And then we're welding on the flanges at the end of the pipes, and we've got to make sure that there's no leaks, of course, and then those will get fitted later on. Now we're moving into the welding bays. Here we can see a wagon that's come out of the assembly jig. At the moment we're doing the flat welding. It's almost like an old-fashioned robot, that's a straight line welder, and that welds at exactly the right speed to weld this critical part of the chassis onto its top web member. And on the right here we have the chassis in the manipulator, and it's important that we put them in the manipulator so that we never try and weld up and down. We're always doing flat straight line welding to get the best quality weld. Once it's finished with the welding, We bring it over here, and this is where we start to assemble a lot of the components that go into a container wagon. You can see that the belly plate has been fitted, and we're now starting to fit the brake piping. Bogey top center casting. We're starting to work on the couplers and a lot of the brake components. And then as we go on, we can just see more bays where we're doing the assembly. A lot of two wagons have just gone out to painting, and that's where we'll go and have a look next with Gary.
This is part of the painting process on the wagons. Before they're painted, a lot of the steels are high pressure cleaned and a lot of it is sandblasted. Then they get an undercoat, drying at a certain temperature, humidity. Once certified, then it'll go to the final painting. This is where we're applying the final coat of paint. It's all stone core product. It's measured wet film thickness, dry film thicknesses. We also measure humidities. This painting spec has been tested in Mozambique as well. We're 6 years, we've still got good quality. All our wagons are made according to AAR, Associated American Railways. So when we put, once they come out of painting, we put them on these bogies here, where we test coupler heights, we test the coupler that it's working, we check the brake, basic braking systems, and this, once we are happy here, that's when it goes to the final preparation in another workshop.
Andrew, I take it this is like final assembly loading, what's happening here?
This is where we bring our wagon frames, we fit the bogies, we fit the brakes, we test all of the brakes, then we do our final quality checks here. And from here is where we then dispatch the wagons. As you can see, we're loading wagons at the moment. These container wagons, we managed to load two wagons on a truck. And these will now be starting a journey all the way to Angola, which should take about a week. At the moment, we are producing just about one wagon every working day, and we send out a batch every week, either 4 or 6 wagons.
And when one considers that it's 275 wagons, I mean, that's an impressive pace that you're maintaining there. So testing and simulating the real working environment of these wagons is quite important. How have you done it here at Galison Manufacturing?
This is the final bay. So this is where, as you can see, these wagons are just about ready to go out. They've had all their painting done, all their markings are done. The bogies are fitted and the brakes have been fitted. The final process is to make sure that those brakes are going to work correctly in the real world. Mm-hmm. And for that we do a single car brake test, which is what is going on here. That test will simulate the brakes working under normal conditions, under emergency conditions. Once we have completed here, we have qualified technicians doing the testing. Certificate will be generated, which can then be passed on to the rail operators.
Does that basically like certify it as operational, or?
That's the final certification. Okay. Obviously, there's a lot of other paperwork behind to go into material specs, manufacturing processes, dimensional checks, but this is the final.
The wagons that we're manufacturing for Angola are container wagons. They're going to be carrying mostly sulfur up into the DRC, and they're going to be carrying copper in containers back to the ports. Axle loading on the line is only 18.5 tons, so it's critical to have a wagon as light as possible, so that way you can carry more cargo. Our wagons have been designed with high strength steel. It's double the strength of normal steel. So whilst they are lightweight, they are also still very robust to handle the conditions, and they can carry up to 3 to 4 tons more than an old-fashioned container wagon in Southern Africa.